Good morning, or good afternoon, good evening, wherever you might be. My name is Roger Gilbert. I'm the publisher of Milling and Grain magazine and International Equifeed. And we have joined with Progressive Agri-Schools of Asia to form jointly the online milling school. And that's in progress now. We're halfway through, just over halfway through a 12-week course. And I have with me today my colleague and partner, Yanis Christodoulou, who is going to talk to us, or join me, and talk about the online milling school. Welcome, Yanis.
Hi, Roger.
Yeah.
Good to be with you again.
Thank you. And likewise, it's timely that we should bring to the attention, a wider attention of the industry, if we can, the development that we've got going here at the online milling school and its importance. So, in your view, Yanis, how did this concept come about?
Right. Look, humble beginnings, I would say, with passion, commitment, and understanding of the industry. And that actually gave us the idea, the concept, and the drive to actually start thinking on how can we, as practitioners in the industry, contribute back to the industry and help the professionals of the industry to develop in their own organizations and help their own companies to develop even better all over the world.
Yeah.
We started initially with a mission of really saying, how can we help the industry? And by speaking to a lot of professionals around, we quickly realized that a training program, a consistent training program, will actually help everybody that operates in the milling world.
Well, of course, the magazine is right behind this. I mean, we were, our magazine's been going 130-odd years in print. And it's challenging times right now with coronavirus and the move towards digital. But of course, you know, our magazine has always been involved in training, especially around milling queries. And since the 70s or 60s, feed has played a very important part in the milling processes. So it's great that we have connected on this issue and see the same future in providing industry with a service, a training service that they can benefit from. And, you know, as I said in my introduction, you know, we're halfway through the first 12-week course, just over. Couple of questions. One is, how have people responded? What has been numbers, etc.? And what's the future?
All right, numbers. I mean, it's thankfully the industry actually did join us from the beginning. From session number one, we actually had 200-300 people attending. And since then, and now we are, I believe, at our ninth session that is coming up next week, we are consistently see an increase in those numbers. And what is really encouraging is, firstly, it's an international audience. So it's from all around the world, especially from countries that they are within the time zones that we are delivering today the program, European, Africa, Middle East, Asia here, all right? So it's been very encouraging to see that so much interest from all around the world about what we are doing. And the embracement we are getting from people that have actually attended. At the end of every session, we do our usual survey, and there is all positive comments that are coming through and encouraging comments that the industry is really saying, hey, keep going with this.
Yeah, yeah. I hear that myself. I mean, it's wonderful to be on those sessions. People are very happy to be there. And they, as you say, they return, and there's an increasing number over time. So the further we reach, the more people we attract. And of course, those time zones are very important, because without broadcasting in a time zone that somebody is working in, you know, it's very difficult, isn't it, to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning to watch a webinar or watch an online course. And with that in mind, I think you'd want to tell our colleagues in Latin America, Central America, and North America that it is available as a rebroadcast on Friday in their time zone around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So we're trying to cover the whole globe. And I think also the other important aspect to me is that we're providing a certificate of attainment. I think people who complete the whole 12 courses will find a benefit in having that documented in a way that they can use that in their CVs or their workplaces. Is that something that you feel is a key benefit in this process of learning?
It is. I mean, it's hard work to go through all the modules we have for us and also for the attendees, right? And there's a lot of learning. And I believe that the modules, the way we have created them, the material, the way we have created them, are next to nothing. I mean, they are fantastic. The detail that goes behind it, the knowledge that is in there, the knowledge sharing, all of these have to be recognized somehow. And a certificate of attendance or a completion of the course, I think, is part of it.
Yeah.
At the end, you're coming out of there and hopefully feeling proud that you have achieved a new step in your career, in your knowledge skills, right? And you have something to show for it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, I've sat, obviously, like yourself, sat through all the sessions so far, and we're learning a lot ourselves.
It's a continuous process, Roger, including us. We're still learning a lot.
We'll be able to get out there and operate feed mills from the end of the 12th session, or get employed in the feed milling industry. But what surprises me more and more each session I watch is how professional those presentations are delivered. And I think this is a key to the fact that we are a school and it's not just a conference presentation. Of course, we have commercial companies involved in making those presentations, but it is around the subject matter and around the technology itself, rather than any particular product or service or something that a company is supplying. So that's the thing that strikes me most, is that this is a school rather than a conference.
Well, you know, thanks for bringing this up. And I think it's very important here to stress the fact that our goal, our mission is always to deliver unbiased, independent, and applicable information to the industry. And what we see in front of us, or what the attendees see as a finished product or as a finished training, actually there is an enormous amount of work that goes at the background before that's is a finished product. We have a board of people, they review the information we have, they contribute to that information. Yes, it's delivered by one specific professional at the end of the day, but actually the work that goes at the background to deliver the develop the material, approve the material, it's enormous. So I hope that our attendees enjoy that and they see the value of having such information in front of them.
Well, I certainly pick up on that. And of course, I mean, interesting, we're always on the lookout for these types of people or professionals in the industry who want to present. I mean, we're not a closed shop. We're trying to do this for the whole industry, and we want to get the whole industry involved. So, you know, on your behalf, if you allow me, you know, I could put out a call right now for somebody who wants to present on a topic that we're addressing to actually contact us. There's always room for one more, as they say.
Roger, I'm with you and fully encourage any industry professional that would like to contribute to the knowledge of the industry. They have ideas around how we can do this program better and longer and bigger. We are always very welcome, and I will say so. Please do come forward. Please let us know if you are interested to contribute. We'll be very happy to engage you in the process. And at the same time, I would like to take this opportunity to say a big thank you to the sponsors. They came forward from day one, and that's very important. To get this going, to get this moving, we need the help and the assistance of the industry. And it was great that we did have some companies that went in a leap from the beginning. They believed on actually what do we do, and they really wanted to support us. And to name a few, if you allow me, Roger.
Yes.
Yemta, Amanda's Car, Agentis Innovations, Doctors Acrovet from Bangladesh, Biovet from Spain, Zoetis in Indonesia. Our companies, they actually stood behind us from the beginning, and they've been supporting us fully since then. And we welcome that, we encourage that, and I will say again, we are open for other companies to come forward and continue to help us on our mission of delivering education.
And that brings me to sort of like a final area of discussion, is that what happens next. And I know that we will be repeating the online milling school that's focused on livestock feed manufacture. So from, I think it is October the 7th, Wednesday, October the 7th, we're repeating the sessions from course or session number one all the way through to session number 12, which is on the, I believe the last day is December the 16th, just before the Christmas break. And those who might have taken up one or two sessions or might have missed a session or want to join and right now and complete all 12 sessions, they can. So that's a very important aspect of this, is that it does roll over, and in the new year it will all start again, of course. And hopefully we will be able to attract more people from different time zones to attend. My question, Yanis, or the area that, you know, we should have a little bit of comment on, is what happens next in terms of the online milling school. It's not just about livestock feed manufacture. There are other aspects to the to our concept.
Oh, absolutely. We do feel encouraged, and we are committed to continue the development not only of the feed mill, livestock feed mill agri-school, as Roger pointed out, but we already started working on an aqua feed milling school and potentially on a pet food school. So all of these are initiatives that we are in the pipeline. We are in the process of developing the material right now, and again, for specialists out there, please do join us. Please come along, and you can help us with the development of the material or delivery of the material.
Yanis, thank you very much. And from my perspective, we don't want to leave flour milling out of this equation either. So, but that's in the future. But just to point everybody in the right direction, it is not on your screen, but it's very simple. It's the one word, onlinemillingschool.com. So please make your way to onlinemillingschool.com and have a look at the program and see how you might participate either in the program or joining us to present it. But Yanis, a final word from you?
Well, I hope that you do join us, and I hope you do enjoy the experience with us. We are fully committed on delivering that to you.
Yeah.
So, Roger, thank you so much. Thank you for your support. Thank you for making this video. And I hope with this we can reach the wider audience and let them know what we are all about and what we are doing.
Okay. So, thank you, Yanis. Onlinemillingschool.com. Don't forget it. Okay, bye for now.